Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be continuing our work on the handmade paving stone project, or well, hand-painted paving stone project. And as you can see, I have the marigold colored stone that I spray painted in one of the earlier videos that we did. And I'm getting ready to pick an image to draw onto the stone itself. And then later on, we'll worry about the colors. All right, I went ahead and finished drawing on the marigold colored stone. I used that picture there from the nature coloring book for inspiration. So that's what it came out like. I drew that freehand with a Sharpie marker. And then later I'm going to go back in and start painting the stone. So it's a gorgeous day out. I decided to open up the door, sit down, and do a little bit of painting. We're going to add the color to this second paving stone. If you remember, I already painted it with a spray paint as a base coat. It's a marigold color, and now I'm going to be using titanium white and this one, can't even pronounce that. It's a, how would you say that? Phthalocyanin blue? Anyway, it's blue. Cerulean blue. Know how to pronounce that one. And an ultramarine blue. We're going to use those for the flowers. Oh, and I have the angled brushes, the same ones that I used before. Angled and then a fine one for detail work. Okay, that's what the flowers look like for now. I have to go back in later and add the greens. And of course the color of the dirt, some browns and yellows, and the sun. But for now, that's what we're working on.
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. It's another day in Southeast Georgia. And today is kind of overcast and rainy outside, so I figured I would continue working on our paving stone for the arbor area, and I'm going to paint the sun, so I'll make my own little sunshine. I will be using today the titanium white, the same angle brushes that I had before, a orange yellow, a yellow ochre, a cadmium yellow, and a lemon yellow to do the sun. Plus, if you remember, the stone itself was already spray painted marigold yellow, so we'll have a little bit of that color built right in as well. And once I am done with the sun, I'll go ahead and give you a peek at what that looks like. All right, I've got all of my colors into my palette. And I'm gonna go ahead and start with this brush here and the brighter. A little bit of water to help it spread along the porous stone. And the water allows me to do a little bit of mixing on the stone. Not much, but just a little blending, I should say. Mixing would be the wrong word. A little bit of blending. Let the sun dry. You can see that's what it looks like now. I did a little more on the rays. I'm going to go ahead and work on the dirt. I'm using yellow ochre, some burnt sienna, and some burnt umber. And we'll go ahead and start on that. Alright, that is what the dirt looks like, the base coat, for now. And I'm going to go ahead and let everything dry so I don't end up with paint all over my arms. And later we'll go back and do some of the stem and a little bit more detail work.
Another day, and I'll be working on another section of the stone. We'll be doing the leaves today, and I have a variety of greens and some titanium white. Now, in case you're wondering what greens, we've got leaf green, this sap green, and viridian green, and that's what we'll be using to get a base coat on the leaves. And that's what it looks like with the first coat of green.
We're outside now. Went ahead and put the other stone in place, the one that we just finished. And there it is. I have two more stones in the car that I have to do, which will probably take me a little bit past that second pole, so I think I'm probably going to need two or three more to finish this particular stretch of walkway. But so far I'm pretty happy with how it looks, and we'll keep you posted on our progress.